BMW has been disappointing their fan base for the longest time with ugly, horrid, and sacrilegious designs. The new M4 does not have the iconic Hofmeister kink, and year by year, BMW has been shying away from using their iconic angel headlights. But the same could be said about BMW almost 10 to 15 years ago, when the E65 7 Series had come out. It was absolutely appalling to look at, and everyone was praying to the car gods that they should leave the good old 5 Series alone with the ugly, ugly design language of that time. But what did we get? The E65 Series.
When it came out, the E65 Series was hated by the masses for its weird and obnoxious design. It didn't even look like something BMW could ever make, and most importantly, it was the most important BMW product at the time after the 3 Series.
I think when the E65 Series had come out, BMW were literally at the top of their game. They had stuffed a V8 under the hood of the M3, and they had also made an X5 with a F1 derived V12 inside it. And I mean, of course, who can forget the legendary E60 V10 M5?
I mean, who could beat a Formula 1 derived BMW in 2005? Reliability, that's who. And moreover, E60 M5s are a rare occurrence in India. Our friends at Horsepower Cartel had one for the longest time, but having them is like having a spoilt Labrador. You love them to death, but to keep it happy, you need to spend tons and tons of money on dog treats.
So what's the next best thing, you ask? Well, it's this, the E60 550i. This is the unsung E60 550i. Everyone looks at the V10 M5 from this era as the definitive fast E60 you can buy, but that's not completely true. Yes, it might not have the V10 from the M5, but keeping the V10 from the M5 in a running condition is super hard. Something had to go wrong, especially with the SMG gearbox.
The 550i might not be the answer to your reliability issues as such, but if you want a fast E60, well, this is one. Under the hood, the 550i gets a 4.8-litre naturally aspirated V8, which sounds like... Yeah, Mustang owners, move aside. The V8 in this made 362 horsepower and 490 Nm of torque, and instead of the struggling SMG gearbox, you used to get the ZF 6-speed auto as the default gearbox, although an SMG could be opted in some countries.
What makes the E60 550i so special in our country is that E60 M5s are at least 10 to 15 in India, at least the ones that I know of, but 550is? Apparently, BMW India had only imported two. One is black and this is the other one, the silver one.
But enough blabbering around. Let's get down to business.
Sounds absolutely manic. So he's gotten a custom exhaust done to this car, and it has a quad tailpipe setup, and it sounds absolutely menacing. Mustang owners, really, move aside, man. German V8s, man. Since the 550i doesn't come with the special adjustable M Sport suspension, the owner has gone out and fitted Bilstein B12 Pro shock absorbers, and it absolutely changes the way this car drives. And stuck onto the suspension parts are some really lightweight and one of the most prettiest set of rims I've ever seen, Vossen HF3s. And wrapped around the wheels are Pirelli P0s, which give this car so much grip. And it is absolutely addictive, the throttle pedal, I tell you. 362 horsepower is more than enough to do anything in India, man. The thing with the 550i is that it's not overwhelming, like the V10 M5. And that's a good thing, because the V10 M5 was twitchy and it was very nervous when it came to corners and other things. It always used to spin up its wheels, whereas this, with the new suspension parts and the big tire upgrade, it handles like a proper sports car, even though it weighs so much. When it comes to the interior, well, it's an early 2000s car, so it's nothing really that great if you compare to today's BMWs. You have the old iDrive system, which is quite easy to use, considering the fact that it has a knob over here to toggle and everything. But apart from that, I mean, this car isn't about the interior. It's nothing close to the interiors that we have today. It's all about this engine, man. Step on it. Throttle. Oh my god. Sounds absolutely mad. And of course, do not look at the fuel economy in this car. 5.2 kilometers to the liter. You should not even look at that. I mean, this is one of the most complete builds I've ever seen in my life. The suspension has been worked upon, the brakes have been worked upon, the engine is in perfect running condition. It sounds absolutely insane. I mean, this is one of my favorite cars in Pune, and I'm so lucky to have the owner as my friend. There is something super special about old German saloon cars that I can't put my finger on. And this car might not be the fastest 5 series in India. It might not even beat probably some nice tuned Volkswagen GTIs also on the drag strip. But that's not what this car is meant about. This car is meant to be something unique, something special. It's something that you don't see every day, and it is just something totally different to what I've seen in India. I mean, you have your M5s, you have your M4s and other E63, RS6s and everything, but this is something completely different. This is like a very well done resto mod job, and it is in pristine condition, and I absolutely love it. After spending some time with this car, I have absolutely fallen in love with it. It is just perfect. All of the mods done to it are not over the top, and they perfectly match the car. And don't forget, this is one of the last naturally aspirated V8s you could ever buy from BMW, which makes it super special. And you need builds like this in India, because we're a country where we don't get the special cars. And outside in Europe or USA, this isn't a special car by any means. But since there are only two in India, and this one is worked upon, this is absolutely amazing. And people like this should be more recognized. That's why we're doing more videos like this. And if you are interested in finding out more about this car and the build the owner is doing, check out his page on Instagram called 550i_kickass. We're putting his link down in the description. While you're down there, check out our website, our Instagram, our Twitter. And thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.